Hello and welcome back to Insightsias. Today we shall discuss and understand about few NASA missions which are less frequently mentioned in the news. These missions might not be so much important for your prelims. Nevertheless, UPSC is fond of asking questions from the space sector. It is therefore better to have a brief overview of these missions which can help you eliminate the wrong answers in the examination hall. So the first mission we have is Airborne Snow Observatory. So this is an Earth-based mission designed to collect the data on the snowmelt flowing out of major water basins in the western United States. This mission focuses on two river basins. One is Tuolumne River Basin in California. Second one is Uncompahgre River Basin in Colorado. And the mission was launched on board Twin Otter aircraft. And please note here that these two river basins are the primary water supply for millions of Americans in the western United States. So out of this, what is important for your prelims? Firstly, the objective of the Airborne Snow Observatory mission. Secondly, focus of the mission, is it regional or has it got the focus across the globe? Thirdly, what are the two rivers on which this mission focuses? And lastly, the location of these two rivers, that is Tuolumne and Uncompahgre. Next mission in line we have is Airborne Visible Infrared Imaging Spectrometer Next Generation Mission. In short, it is called as AVIRIS-NG mission. So the objective of this mission is to provide continued access to high signal to noise ratio imaging spectroscopy measurements in the solar reflected spectral range. So what is relevant for your prelims here? See, the question might be asked like, Airborne Visible Infrared Imaging Spectrometer Next Generation Mission concentrates on which kind of electromagnetic radiation? Does it focus on radio waves, microwaves, infrared waves, visible light rays or ultraviolet rays? So what you need to remember is the focus is on infrared rays. And the next mission is Advanced Spaceborne Thermal Emission and Reflection Radiometer. In short, it is called as ASTER. Well, you need to remember two things here. One is, this instrument is one of the five instruments aboard NASA's Terra satellite. And secondly, the instrument's data are used to create detailed maps of land surface temperature, emissivity, reflectance and elevation on Earth. And the data is also used to provide detailed views of the effects of global climate change and extreme weather on Earth's landforms and topography. So what is ASTER mission related to? It is used to create detailed maps of land surface temperature, emissivity, reflectance and elevation on Earth, and it is also used to understand the effects of global climate change and extreme weather on Earth's landforms and topography. Next we have is Atmospheric Infrared Sounder. So it was launched in 2002 and it is a key tool for climate studies on greenhouse gases and carbon dioxide distribution. And it was launched on Aqua satellite, and basically what it does is, it is designed to collect climate data and turn it into 3D maps of air and surface temperature, water vapor and cloud properties. This in turn will help improve researchers' understanding of severe weather patterns and how they relate to global climate change. So the focus of Atmospheric Infrared Sounder, or popularly known as AIRS mission, is to study greenhouse gases and carbon dioxide distribution and prepare 3D maps. Next in line is the Autonomous Science Craft Experiment. So what is significant about this experimental mission is that it can autonomously make decisions about what data to collect, process that data and send it back to Earth. Please note here that whatever missions we are discussing or talking about are solely managed by NASA. They are not in joint collaboration with any other space agencies, means space agencies of other countries. Now let us take up the next mission, which is CloudSat. This uses advanced radar to examine the inner structure of clouds, helping researchers better understand how severe tropical cyclones as well as climate changes related to clouds occur. And from 2010, it has been given a new task. That is, it has embarked on a new mission phase to study the genesis and patterns of tropical cyclones. So please understand here, CloudSat not only concentrates on clouds, it also tries to understand the genesis and patterns of tropical cyclones, which means it has got two objectives. And some of the key discoveries made by CloudSat include, it has revealed how often the clouds above Earth rain and snow. It has also revealed how much ice and water are contained in clouds globally. And further, it has allowed scientists to understand how often and how quickly rain develops in clouds. It has also provided the first quantitative estimate of global snowfall. So next we have is disturbance reduction system, which was designed as part of the Space Technology 7 project. It is an experimental system for measuring gravitational waves in space. Now why these gravitational waves in space are important? Because they are thought to contain important data about the history of the whole universe. And next important fact is that this system was incorporated into the European Space Agency's LISA Pathfinder spacecraft. So what is the disturbance reduction system related to? It is related to measuring gravitational waves in space. Now let us quickly study about the LISA Pathfinder. Here LISA stands for Laser Interferometer Space Antenna. It is a space-based gravitational wave observatory concept that has been studied in great detail both by NASA and ESA. It was formerly called as SMART-2, which means Small Missions for Advanced Research in Technology 2. Well, please note that it is an ESA-led mission, which means it is not handled alone by the European Space Agency. The other agencies involved are from France, Germany, Italy, the Netherlands, Spain, Switzerland, UK and the US Space Agency NASA, as we have already seen. So the next NASA mission we have is Ecosystem Spaceborne Thermal Radiometer Experiment on Space Station, which is popularly known as the EcoStress. The focus of this mission is to monitor one of the most basic processes in living plants. What is it? The loss of water through tiny pores in leaves. And what is this process called as? It is called as the transpiration. And when similar process takes place in human beings, we call it as sweating. And please note here that it is not just transpiration that EcoStress focuses upon. It focuses on evapotranspiration. What is it? It is the combined evaporation and transpiration. And the main questions that this mission seeks to answer is, firstly, how is the terrestrial biosphere responding to changes in water availability? Second, how do changes in diurnal vegetation water stress impact the global carbon cycle? And thirdly, can agricultural vulnerability be reduced through advanced monitoring of agriculture water consumptive use and improved drought estimation? And main scientific objectives of this mission is to identify critical thresholds of water use and water stress in key climate sensitive biomes, for example tropical or dry transition forests or boreal forests, etc., and to detect the timing, location and predictive factors leading to plant water uptake decline. And lastly, it is to measure the agricultural water consumptive use. So these are some of the important NASA missions which might be helpful somewhere in your prelims. In future discussions, we shall take more such topics which are relevant for your prelims 2020.